Join me in prayer in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Place your hand over your heart and say this with me, Lord.
Lord,
prepare my heart.
Prepare my heart
for the movement of the Holy Spirit.
For the movement of the Holy Spirit.
We consecrate to you.
We consecrate to you.
Everything in my life.
Everything in my life.
Our past to your mercy.
Our past to your mercy.
Our present to your love.
Our present to your love.
And our future to your providence.
And our future for your providence.
This we pray.
This we pray.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name. Amen.
Everybody give the Lord a big, big hand. Thank you, Jesus. As a reflection for the gospel today, ito ang title ng ating talakayan. And let's see it in the screen. It's titled, Preparing for Pentecost. Can you kindly look at the person beside you? What do you see? Do you see an Easter person? Do you see a Pentecost person? O isang taong naiwan sa Biyernes Santo? Maganda yung sinabi ni St. Augustine, we are an Easter people and hallelujah is our song. Ito na naman, as a part of the journey of the church, on Sunday will be Ascension Sunday. Aakyat na sa langit ang actually, umakyat na sa langit, pero ginugunita natin. Because remembering is very important also in our faith. And on the next Sunday will be Pentecost, and we commemorate God's empowerment to us. Have you ever wondered, again, look at the person beside you from head to toe, the person to your left and to your right. Have you ever wondered bakit mabait yung katabi mo? Bakit sobrang talino? Bakit hindi tumatanda? Bakit mas sobra pero mas masaya pa rin? Kanina, culture, pag naririnig natin yung kagaya ng very healthy, yun nangyayari kay Ninang, it's something that I am studying and I want to enter in. Ask me, what's that? Age reversal. Oh my gosh. Yung mga 25 pa lang, huwag kayong mag-age reversal. Baka pagpasok nyo bukas, sanggol na. Age reversal. That's very important and it's highly possible. Niri-research ko at ginagawa ko. Nonetheless, the scripture said in John 15:26, when the advocate or the Holy Spirit or the paraclete or the helper in some versions of the Bible comes, whom I will send from the Father, the Spirit of truth that proceeds from the Father, he will testify to me. Can you kindly say this with me? Spirit of truth. Kanina, I was being mentored and rebuked at the same time by Ninang Del. Ang mga tao, we have ambitions in life, we have dreams in life. I'm studying philosophy and I'm studying education. I'm studying philosophy of education. I realized, ang buhay pala ay hindi yung pangarap mo matutupad. Each passing day is an unfolding of the truth. Each passing day, nagiging mas totoo ka kaysa sa dati. We are all drawn to genuineness. Meron ako I was in a healthy and vigorous conversation with one of my professors. Bakit ang daming tao galit na galit kay Simon Cowell? Pero sikat na sikat si Simon Cowell. Have you ever wondered? Because the guy is authentic. If the person beside you, look, is authentic, palakpakan natin si Lord. Para nag-hesitate yung iba. Let's see the next slide. Ayan. Something gets into us. There are tendencies, there are human tendencies keeping us from experiencing our personal Pentecost. And when I speak about Pentecost, it's the daily empowerment. Bakit may mga tao parang energetic palagi? Bakit may mga tao palaging committed? Bakit may mga tao na parang inspiring all of their lives? And the wonderful thing is that yung mga inspiring na tao, they're not happy all the time, and they're honest about it. In one of my talks, I in the feast, sabi ko, do you think I'm preaching now from point of inspiration? Sabi ko, I'm sad within me. And let's study this. According to the gospel today, magandang pag-aralan, what's keeping us from our personal Pentecost? Bakit may mga panahon na disempowered tayo? Who among you would like to know that? Raise your hand. Okay. Let's see the next slide. Tendencies. The first tendency is when we become a deserter. Brother Obet, alam ko yan. Yan yung mga taong mahilig mag-desert. Hindi. A deserter is a person. Next to the Bible, my most well-read book in my personal library is Sun Tzu and the Art of War. At sabi sa Sun Tzu and the Art of War, do not veer away from the troops very far and so long because you will be mistaken as an enemy. Kaya, there is such a thing as maverick. Maganda yung word na maverick. Yun yung pangalan ni Tom Cruise sa, di ba? Sa kanyang iconic na character. Anyway, my dear friends, do not veer away from the ideals of the troop. Mapapagkamalang kang deserter. May mga tao, when the going gets rough, nagwo-walk away. Nagli-leave the group. Ikaw ba yung taong sobrang matampuhin na tuwing the going gets rough at may challenging at na-offend ka ng konti? Are you a walk-away king or a walk-away queen? Straight talk. Who among you would like people who are loyal to you? Raise your hand. Ayaw? Parang sanay na tayo na okay. Every one of us, of course. You know what? Simon Sinek wrote a book, and the book is titled, Leaders Eat Last. It wasn't said there, but the entire book was saying, you want loyalty? Give it to your people. Sa principles ng Light of Jesus Family kay Bo Sanchez, sinabi niya sa amin, you must be loyal to your people even if they are not loyal to you. Wow! Practice nga. Tingin sa katabi. Sabi mo, you know what? I'm loyal to you. Ngayon, pag parehas kayong single, tapos ngayon lang kayo nagkatabi, baka meant to be, sabi mo, I'm devoted to you. Loyalty is very precious nowadays. Please do not be a deserter. Ang sarap-sarap sabihin, kayo na lang dyan. May problema, may audit findings, kayo na lang dyan. Do not be a deserter. It's human tendency. No matter how hurt you are, give loyalty to whom it is due. And I want to define an angle of toxicity today. It's when leaders are not loyal to their people and they're exacting loyalty from them. Alam mong loyal yung leader mo kapag sinabing, don't talk directly to my people, talk to me first. Alam nyo, I have a confession to make. For 14 years, I've been employed in a government bank. Won't tell you anymore, it's Land Bank of the Philippines. Ang higpit-higpit ng supervisor ko, sobrang higpit sa attendance at lahat, sa sermonan ka pa. Pero mahal na mahal ko siya. Ninang ko eh. Pero every time the department is attacked, you don't talk to my people. You talk to me. Loyal na loyal pala siya. Can you kindly place your hand over your heart and say this with me, beginning today and for the rest of my life, I will never be a deserter. Magdi-desert na lang ako. Yan, palakpakan natin si Lord. Next human tendency. Huwag kayong mag-alala, tatlo lang to. Next human tendency, another letter D. Let's see it again. Puro letter D itong human tendency. Discriminator. Buti pa si Bamboo, hindi nagdi-discriminate. Sabi niya, hindi pula't dilaw tunay na magkalaban. Ang kulay at tatak ay di siyang daylan. Hanggat marami ang lugmok sa kahirapan at ang gustisya ay para lang sa mayaman. Are we discriminating? I don't want to listen to that speaker. He doesn't speak English. Ayoko makipag-usap. Hindi ako makarelate. They're so poor. May mga ganun. No such thing as discrimination. If you watch The Chosen, makikita mo doon si Lord walang pinipili. Ang VIP para sa kanya ay hindi yung mga mayayaman, hindi mga sikat. But the VIP for Jesus Christ are those at the outskirts of community life. Don't tell me, ay, hindi ako ganyan. Oo, totoo. Bakit pagpasok sa opisina or sa mall or sa group of in a party, meron tayong automatic na mimili ng kauri natin? Yes? Okay. As a commitment, smile at the friend next to you and tell that person, sa totoo lang, sabi mo, gusto kong maging close sa'yo. Pantay-pantay lang tayo. Come on! Palakpakan natin si Lord. Ang ganda ng sinabi ni Bishop Bacani. Sabi ni Bishop Bacani, darating ang panahon, ang katotohanan ng buhay ay ihahayag dahil ang katotohanan ng buhay ay parang isang game na chess. Yes, in your waking moment, in your active life, some of us are kings, some of us are bishops. Sabi niya, I am a bishop. Some of us are knights. Some of us are pawns. Some are officers, some are not. But at the end of the life, nililigpit daw yung chest at papasok lahat sa wooden box. And everyone is pantay-pantay. Sabi ng isang kaibigan kong politiko, nanakay Lord, sabi niya, be careful whom you hurt as you go through the ladder of success. Because they're the very same people that you will meet going downstairs. Kaya ako kinakaibigan ko mga security guard, mga helpers. Kasi sa totoo lang, kasi laking bagong baryo ako eh. Sa dulo ng buhay, pag nagkagipitan, sila yung parang pader na napaka-loyal sa'yo. Let's move on. The third and last one, as a human tendency. Then we will go to the discussion about the Holy Spirit. Destructor. Napakadaling manira. Napakadaling alam mo yon? I think it's the most convenient thing to do to be a destructor. The hour is coming when everyone who kills you will think that he is offering worship to God. Grabe, no? Sabi nga ni, alam mo nung tinanong si, hindi nyo na naabutan yun, si Eva Eugenio, anong malakas na bagyo na sumapit sa Pilipinas? Hindi siya sumagot, kumanta siya. Sabi niya, kay rami ng winasak na tahanan, kay rami ng matang pinaluha, kay rami ng... May mga kaedad yata ako sa area na to. O tukso, layuan mo ako. The most difficult and most worthwhile thing to do on earth is to build up a person. And the most convenient thing to do ay sirain ang isang tao. As an executive coach, my dear friends, I consult with bosses of company, with officers of agencies. Alam ninyo, sometimes hindi nila matanggap na sila yung toxic. And sometimes there are people, ang kanilang way of life ay magpaka-toxic. Masaya sila pag may nagre-retire dahil sa kanila. Masaya sila pag may sumusukong mga tao dahil sa kanila. That's why, in executive coaching, the parameter I use is Marshall Goldsmith, what got you here won't bring you there. There's no such thing as a leaderless leader. The biggest room in the world is a room for improvement. Yes? Alam mo bang yung katabi mo, mapopromote pa yan ng todo? Pero dapat bumait muna siya ng todo? Sino sa inyo ang sasaya pag yung katabi mo maging super mega bait, pumalakpak sa Panginoon? Oh, woo! So, tayong lahat. So, we discuss about the human tendencies. Tingnan naman natin pag tinulungan tayo ng Banal na Espiritu. Let's see more. Yan. Why do we become a deserter, a discriminator, and a destructor? Let's see next. Bakit tayo nagkakaroon ng ganyan? The scripture said, because of ignorance of God. And St. Jerome, the writer of the Bible, said, ignorance of the scripture is the ignorance of God. They will do this because they have not known either Father or me. St. Peter people, every Monday, the Lord is revealing Himself to you. Pag tinawag tayo, hindi mo pwedeng i-deny na hindi ko kilala si Lord. We have to know Him. Let's see the next slide. This is what we do. We need the Holy Spirit. We'll invite the Holy Spirit today. Sabi ni Pierre Teilhard de Chardin, is a missionary, a Jesuit, we are not human beings having a spiritual experience. We are spiritual beings having a physical experience. Ang katabi mo ay hindi pwedeng araw-araw magsabing, tao lang. Lahat tayo ay espiritu na nasa katawang tao pa. When I discovered this for the first time, yun yung dahilan ba't ako nagsumikap, nag-aral uli, I improve myself because as a spiritual person, I think my growth will be limitless. You want an idea to be limitless? Pag may Disney Plus app ka, hanapin mo yung Limitless ni Thor, ni Chris Hemsworth, and you'll know why. Let's see next. How can we experience our personal Pentecost? Let's see next. Kung kanina, puro letter D, ito puro letter R. Everybody read together. 1, 2, 3. Recharge. Recharge, hindi discharge. Recharge. Every Monday, do not look at the prayer meeting as another obligation. Lakad na naman, talk na naman, kanta na naman. Darating, sasayaw, uupo, makikinig, uuwi. Darating, sasayaw. No. Look at this Monday. You're blessed because the ideal that I desire, I pray, bawat kumpanya, sana, first thing in the morning, ng first day of work, may prayer meeting. The ideal that I want in the world is being modeled by this company. Palakpakan natin si Lord. Recharge. Alam nyo ba, one of the reasons why I say yes to the invitation here is to consult with my ninang and to see you, the people I look up to. Ang hirap-hirap kayang mag-talk sa mga taong kinabibiliban mo. But use this as a recharging moment for your life. Let's see next. Next letter R would be reveal. Wow. Nung panahon ng pandemic, naka-face mask lahat. Ang daming nagka-inlaban sa mata't kilay lang. Nung nag-face reveal, sabi niya, balik mo na face mask mo. Maraming mga na-disappoint. My dear friends, every day is a revelation. This message is confirmed by the prophecy of Ninang Del a while ago. Kailangan part ng ating mission na ipakilala si Lord. Hindi mo bili ng St. Peter, pero binili ang Diyos sa puso mo. I think you are a win. Ipakilala mo si Lord. Huwag naman kagad-kagad. May prospect kang client, kumpanya. Alam, kilala niyo na ba si Jesus Christ? Huwag naman kagad ganun-ganun. Along the way, they will feel that. Anong palatandaan? Sir? O kaya, ma'am? Bakit ang bait-bait niyo? Yan na. Bukod sa ang ganda-ganda niyo pa, yan na. Sabi mo, alam kasi, every Monday may prayer meeting kami. Yan ang secret ko. And then you reveal the Lord. Ako nagpapasalamat sa mga taong hindi natakot na ipakilala ang Diyos sa aking buhay. Yes? Last but not least, let's see. Reflect. Pagka nag-recharge ka, tas pinakilala mo si Lord, do not miss the chance to reflect. That's the movement of our Pentecost life. Magre-recharge ka every Monday or yung personal prayers mo, then you will reveal the Lord in your work, you will testify, you will witness, then you stop and reflect. Sabi ni St. Blaise Pascal, the problem of humanity is that they don't stop by the side of their bed and reflect. Bago ka matulog, wag diretso tulog. Magmuni-muni ka. Tanungin mo si Lord, deto ba? Deto ba? You reflect. An unreflected life is not worth living, sabi ni Socrates. I have told you this so that when there are comes, you may remember that I told you. Let's see the last slide. Experience your Pentecost, my dear friends. Every day, recharge. Every day, don't miss the opportunity to reveal God by your life and by your word. Sabi ni St. Francis, preach the word. If necessary, speak. Kasi yung taong na kay Lord, kitang-kita sa ugali, sa attitude, and then reflect. Never miss the chance to be quiet every day and just reflect. on the goodness of God. One of the best gifts that the speaker can give you is honesty. What I confessed to my ninang a while ago, I'm going to share with you. I'm going to call this quick last sharing. I want to title it, Fast Track. Si Lord pina-fast track. Sino dito nagpipray na i-fast track ni Lord ang buhay niya? It depends, di ba? Kung promotion, okay. Pero pagka, ano, mahirap. So, one is a bit challenging and the other is a blessing. Fast track is this. I admit, nung nag-pandemic, I become lax in my physical training. Grabe po ako mag-workout dati. Kasi nga, boksingero ako since age 14. Not the formal boxing. I was a street fighter. Yung pinagpupustahan sa kalye, makakain lang. I was like that and I continued on working out. That's the reason I can do 100 push-ups without any trouble. Kaya lang, itong misis ko may nararamdaman daw sa chest niya, may chest pain siya. Siya gusto magpa-check up, nadamay ako. Ayan tuloy, may nakita sa akin. It's alarming at first. I have to share this with you, baka akala nyo lahat ng testimony ng preacher, eh, masaya. Natakot ako ha. Kasi okay yung ECG ko. Okay yung aking 2D echo. Sa stress test, talagang competitive pa ako. Yun nga lang, hindi ko na natapos yung last stage. Kasi ang naging lax nga ako, I don't run anymore, I just walk. Kasi pag naglalakad, nakaka-reflect, nakaka-pray ng rosaryo, nagkaroon daw ng fluctuations. To make the long story short, later, after this, I will go to the heart center and schedule for angiogram. May konting fluctuation. Yes, 50 has happened. Pero kinounsel ako ng kaibigan kong doktor. Sabi niya, Brother Obed, buti na lang may kaibigan doktor. Sabi niya, alam kong lalapit ka pag may ganyang condition. All my reads are okay. Sabi niya, kung ako lang ang kausap mo, no need for angiogram, pero covered naman ng health card mo, go for it. Kung ang goal mo ay magstay sa current health level mo, we're okay, huwag ka na magpa-angiogram. Pero dahil nga libre, covered naman ng health card mo, go ahead because it's gonna be our baseline because you entrusted me, you're gonna get back to extreme physical fitness and I'm gonna coach you. God is good? It's still good all the time. Palakpakan natin si Lord. So pray for me. The second one is this. Nung nag-pandemic, nagturo ako online. The word teacher and educator and professor is something that I would not ascribe to myself. Pero meron nag-grow sa akin, ngayon nagdo-doctoral ako. And thank you, St. Peter, for being instrumental in my studies. Tapos na po ako sa aking coursework. Pumasa naman ako sa aking kompre. I'm writing now my dissertation. Something grew in me. And that is, Lord, ano kayang pakiramdam ng magturo sa universidad na buong buhay ko, pinag-aral ako ng libre? Ang dinagdag ko sa bucket list is to teach in the University of the Philippines. Pagsulat ko sa aking journal, nag-text yung aking senior professor, Sir Obed, we want to invite you to be lecturer in UP. It's a program lang naman. Pero be a lecturer, it's a three-part program. Pangatlo yung sa'yo. Speak about your dissertation, which is philosophical coaching. Sabi ko, Lord, ang bilis mo naman mag-answer. Tapos wala pang dalawang oras, tumawag uli siya at sabi, Sir, we also consider you for full-time professorship. Yeah. Kaya, two Thursdays ago, kabadong-kabado kasi may online interview ang tatalino ng mga profesor. Sabi ko, Lord, sana sapakan na lang kahit dalawa, okay lang sa akin, 5 minutes, pwede. But you know what? I claim God's promise that during testing, you will not speak, but God will speak through you. I was able to ace it. Eh ngayon, matagal po ang gobyerno eh. We're just waiting for the result. But I think it's a win-win. Kasi ang huling tinek sa akin, Sir, if you get the professorship, Hindi ka na lecturer. Galing, yun lang ang ano doon. It's a win-win situation. So that's my prayer to you, my dear friends. May the Lord fast-track what needs to be fast-tracked in your life by the power of a personal Pentecost. Everybody stand up. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Dear God, today is very simple. It's an ordinary Monday. But as we worship, we open every area of our lives, mind, body, soul, and spirit. Lord, I pray for the most hesitant person here, that this person, he or she, will experience an extraordinary dose of your grace today and reveal to him who my Lord is, who his God is, who her God is. This we declare in Jesus' name.
Joining us. View our past broadcast on the St. Peter Community YouTube channel and St. Peter Community Facebook page. Don't forget to like, to share, to subscribe, and hit the bell so you can be notified on our upcoming activities. Maraming salamat po at laging tandaan, unahin natin lagi ang Diyos.